Yeah, I know, I know. Another new game? But look, this game just looks so intensely awesome that I just can't wait and I want to play it right now. And I thought I'd take you guys with me on the first run, like I always do.
Please log in.
This is Frozen Synapse. It's a tactical strategy game, and it looks very, very cool. Okay, so you can play online. I really don't have any interest in that. Server will be slow. Yeah, let's stick to offline.
Offline mode enabled.
Well, I guess we should just start with the tutorial. Okay, welcome. Thank you. I'm sure we're both gonna really enjoy this. Select the unit, right? Oh, okay, I can right. That's nice. So I can use the right mouse to click and hold. Can I zoom? Yes, I can. I can zoom. All the way in? All the way in. Wow. Are these lines gonna be here throughout the whole time? Looks like I'm looking through a screen. Anyways, we'll see. Okay, select the unit. Roger that. To move the unit somewhere, make a waypoint by double left clicking. Oh, I think I can handle that. Yeah, astonishing. Make another waypoint over here, this time by right clicking in the box selected to add waypoint. Now, move the waypoint from the green box to the other green box by dragging it. Okay. Nice. So you can change. Can I do that with this as well? Oh, tutorials like that kind of annoy me, where they're locked in and you're not allowed to experiment. Oh well. Finally, delete all waypoints by hitting backspace a couple of times. That's backspace, not delete, which is used to delete individual plan elements. Hey. All right. When you place a waypoint, the system will calculate the best route of getting you to it. Sometimes you want to override this. Oh, I have to play. This graphic right here reminds me a lot of God, what the hell is that? System Shock 2. Maybe that's what he was thinking. All right, to do this, another way, hold down Shift. Right, so that's like an automated. Like, I want to go there, and then he'll work his way there himself, and I don't have to like click. All right, okay. Now let's look at combat. Yeah, here we go. The good stuff. Next. To win an encounter, you must consider four aspects: range, stillness, aiming, and cover. Stillness? Does he mean stealth? Or actually standing still? That seems, well, this is weird. Oh, let's look at what happens here. Oh, wipeout. Okay, our green unit was standing still. He had time to repair. Okay, so I guess, yes, stillness does mean standing still. His red antagonist had superior cover, however. Cover is vital and one of the most important aspects of combat. On the tactical display, the dark blue cuboids are full height walls. That's these parts right here, I would assume. The light blue cuboids are half height objects: boxes, windows, tables, etc. So that's this area. Oh, okay, I get it. You can duck behind them and not be seen, and you can shoot over them in cover, giving you a considerable fire advantage. Okay, that's very cool. Let's quickly look at the time controls at the bottom of the screen. It's pretty simple. Just press the, is that a K? Oh, that's back button. Okay, what? To go to the beginning of the turn, and push the, okay, that's play and pause. Okay, so it's just like a regular player. Very straightforward, just press play to see the action again, and we'll move on. Look out! Simple graphics, but it's highly effective. It's very cool. Matches are divided into turns. Every turn has a planning phase and an outcome. In the planning phase, you make plans, really? Wow. For your units, and test them by pressing play, just as we have been doing, alright? That's fine. When your plan is complete, hit the prime button to commit it. You don't need to do that now. Click next. Okay, so that's like submit. I make all my turns and then I'll submit. Okay. In a moment, we'll test this plan and see what happens. The objective is to shoot from behind the window and eliminate this red enemy. Red. Machine gunners engage automatically when they acquire visual on a hostile. Okay. Oh, death! Alright, our unit gets shot before he can get to cover, obviously. To evade this attack, we need to use a continue on sight order. This will make our unit continue moving without engaging. Very useful. Select the highlighted waypoint with the left mouse button. Yeah, because that's the spot where he gets shot. Okay, now open the orders menu by right-clicking and select continue on sight, obviously. Oh, look at this. There's continue on sight. Add waypoint, cancel aim, check. Engage on sight, stand, duck, clear, focus. Oh, there's focus on zone, ignore zone, focus on... That's very cool. Alright, continue on sight. Good. The order has been added onto the plan. Click next. Ah, he doesn't stop. We're getting there. But we now want our unit to revert back to his default state. Engage on sight. In order to take this hostile out... Oh, engage on sight in order to take this out. Okay. Select the highlighted waypoint. Right, so when you issue a command, it lasts throughout until you counter it. Okay, let's see here. Open the orders and select the engage on sight. Engage. Make it so. Alright, let's play. Click next. Sweet. Congratulations, you are no longer a total incompetent. Let's move on to something more stimulating. That almost sounds perverse. By default, units aim in the direction they are traveling. It is possible, thankfully, to aim any direction we choose. Alright. Select the highlighted waypoint. Roger that. The aim handle is always floating near your current selection. It's a small circular icon which looks like a crosshair. Oh, there it is. Oh, there's another one down there. What the? Oh. Drag this out onto the green box over the left-hand enemy. Ah, like that. The aim line we have created forces the unit to look in the direction of the arrow and continue looking there as he moves along. When a unit is aiming, he will move more slowly, however. He will also have an advantage when he engages an enemy. Ah, okay. Very cool. That's like SWAT team when they have their guns up going, woo! Moving forward nice and slow and steady. Alright, time to do something on your own. Click on the next waypoint in the plan, then create another aim line to take out that unit on the right. When you're happy, press play to test your plan. When you have successfully taken out the two hostiles, we will move on. Okay, that's this one, and then there. I don't get it. Why does a box jump all the way to the... That's strange. You may not be able to divine this from my demeanor, but I am unbelievably impressed. Yes. Wow, I'm actually pretty impressed so far. not because he just said it, but the game. This seems pretty clever. Okay, aiming is useful, but sometimes you'll want to revert units to their default state. Select the highlighted waypoint inside the green glowing box. Open orders and choose cancel aim. Ah. As you can see, Your unit stops aiming when he executes the cancel aim order. He will now move faster, looking straight ahead, but lose his aiming advantage. What would the numbers mean? All right, here's a new situation. As you can see, we have a unit in some difficulty. We have a basic plan, but it doesn't look like our unit will escape. Oh dear. A small clock-like circle in the lower right of every waypoint is a time handle. Ah, that's another icon, okay. If you drag it to the right, our unit will wait there for some time. Have it go with first waypoint. Good. Waiting about 2 seconds. Okay, 2 seconds, let's do that. There we go. Your first waypoint, you get a unit out there alive. Get our unit out there alive. You can use the spacebar as a shortcut for the play button, by the way. Test the plan now by playing it. Good work. Let's move on. Units can duck behind cover. The order is available from the right-click orders menu, or you can shortcut to the D. That was very nice. Okay, your unit ducks behind the crate and shoots the first enemy. He needs to turn to face the other before he comes around the crate. Select the unit. Okay, select. Whoa, look at all this. Select the unit, drag out the time handle. Then drag. What, I'm supposed to wait longer? Is that what he wants? Then drag the aim handle to create an aim line. Oh, that's like a, from that point, you want him to aim. If it's too much, you can skip. I don't want to skip. What the hell? That was wrong. Alright, let's see here. We're supposed to select. Well, maybe I want a shorter. And then I'll aim. Yeah, that's probably the key. Let's try that. Oh yeah! Very good. Time to cause some ridiculous explosions. Ooh, really? Units with explosive projectiles, rocket launchers, and grenade launchers behave differently to other unit types, in that they don't engage automatically. Believe me, it's better that way. You should have seen the early tests. Essentially, you have to tell them where and when to fire. Fire a rocket by using the aim handle. Select the rocket launcher unit and create an aim line to blow a hole in this wall. Press play to test the plan. We'll move on when all the hostiles have been neutralized. Okay, so here's the rocket guy. Select the rocket launcher unit. Create an aim line to blow like that. Oh, very cool. Explosions are usually fun for all involved. I like that effect. That was pretty cool. Alright, let's continue. Oh, a sniper. Did you see that? That reminded me of the railgun. I want to see that again. From Quake. Hell, look at that. How can we resolve the situation? We want our unit to pop out and shoot the nearer enemy before the sniper gets his shot off. We then want to move around and engage the sniper. We need to tell our unit to ignore the sniper to begin with. Select the highlighted waypoint. Now, right-click on the sniper. Select ignore enemy. There it is. Good. We want to target him later on, though. So select the newly highlighted waypoint. Yeah, of course, we want to cancel. Select clear, focus, ignore. Oh, it's on the bottom here. Good. From looking at you, I can tell you'll need further help. This can be acquired by clicking the question mark icon on the top left of the main menu. Don't do this now, we don't have time. You can also click on the question mark icon at other times. In multiplayer games, it will give you some brief information about the current game mode. In single player games, it will replay the mission briefing at any point. Your training is complete. I feel that we have both achieved something today. Oh, I wanted to play that out. Anyways, that was a decent length. Yeah. Very cool. This seems promising. I'll quit the video here. You know, I'll keep that at this one being the tutorial, and then I'll play the campaign in the next video, which will probably be a little bit later on. Alright guys, thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoy this. It looks like a really interesting game, and I'm pretty excited to see how we progress through this.